bait's getting excited. Oh, he's been bit. He's been bit. Oh, he's jumping out there. He's jumping out. Oh, I don't know if this electric fence reel is going to be able to handle this.
I hope you've been enjoying this delve back into the past of some of the classic episodes from ITM Fishing, my early days of making fishing television. Now this episode here, which is part three, which has taken us from fishing out on the beautiful Ultimate Lady through to my mission of catching a marlin on a budget of $20. Only in this episode, I guess it is the birth of stunt fishing. Catching a marlin on an electric fence reel, and it wasn't a small marlin either. One of the most thrilling catches of my life, in fact. At this stage of my career, I'd caught almost 1,000 marlin, and not to sound like a smart ass, but I'd forgotten about hundreds of them. This fish, to this day, I remember every moment of it, because it was like catching my first one all over again. So, relive it with me in the context that I was genuinely freaking out trying to catch this great fish on a hand line, and it kicked off a whole new line of adrenaline-filled fishing stunts, which, thank goodness, I survived, obviously. Enjoy.
With settled weather conditions and report of marlin on the coast, I set off once again to try and catch a marlin on a handline. And it wasn't long before I found birds working amongst large shoals of skipjack tuna. This was just the sort of thing I was looking for. So I deployed a small tuna lure on the handline, and it wasn't long before I caught a skipjack tuna that would make a perfect live bait. Tuna require a lot of water flow, and they're not able to be kept alive in conventional live bait tanks. So, with no way of keeping the tuna alive, I had to rig it quickly and get it back into the water in the hope that my rigged live bait would stand out from the thousands of other tuna in the area and attract the attention of a hungry marlin.
Welcome to Marlin on a Handline Attempt 2. We've got a beautiful day, we're out on the east coast, and we're trying to catch that marlin on a handline. All we need now is for that marlin to turn up and eat this bait, and it's going to be all on. Going on, the bait's getting excited. He's been bit! I'm gonna try and turn the boat here to the front. Oh, he's jumping out there! He's jumping out! Oh, I don't know if this electric fence reel is gonna be able to handle this! Oh! Okay. I've got to get this boat turned. Well, after all this time waiting, I just rigged up a fresh tuna, put the tuna out, and wham, the marlin is coming and eating it. It almost jumped in the boat. Oh, man, excitement is tying me. I'm probably moving along at about 3 or 4 knots at the moment, so there's going to be a lot of strain on this fish while it's tying me. I've just managed to subdue it. I've got burns on my arm from the line as it wrapped out, but at the moment everything's under control. Tell you what, my heart's going. Whoa. As it sort of came up in the air, I could see the big skippy shaking out of its mouth. And I was thinking, please, please don't throw the hook. And thus far, it's still attached. And I'm just sort of letting it tow me at the moment. And from what I could see, it was a really nice sized fish too. Striped marlin, but a really nice one. So I better concentrate on what I'm doing. I'm very conscious when I'm doing this of pulling in the loose line and having the loose line go around my feet, because of course I don't want to get dragged over by the fish. Oh man, here it goes.
Oh, he's jumping out there, he's jumping out.
Okay, now this fish is starting to dig in, and I'm really sort of worried about him changing direction and coming under me, because I've got no one driving the boat. I've got a whole lot of slack line behind me, and I've got a couple of rods and stuff in here. Guess all I can do is take my time. I tend to think that he's pretty well hooked. but it's a long way away from being caught yet. Man, my heart is racing. It was so exciting, I tell you. Catching big fish is one thing, but catching a big fish from a boat this small on your own, it just raises the stakes so much. I mean, I've probably caught hundreds of striped marlin this size, but not from a boat this small. And to try and slip some line out carefully, so I don't want it to break. It's sort of going straight down now, this fish, so it could come up anywhere. Just sort of paying out a little bit of line. And I hope that he's going to tire out. It's a shame that this old support boat wasn't nearby when it bit, because it literally almost jumped in the boat. Man. I've been asking for this moment to happen for such a long time. Hopefully I can pull it off. Yeah, line angle's coming up. When this fish took off, my custom-made hand line out of an electric fence reel just about blew to bits. Here it goes, it's taking line now. You can see that's just sort of paying out off the electric fence reel nice and slow. But when this fish bit, that thing was going 100 miles an hour. Just about rattled itself to bits. Do you reckon it might be worth you getting your dive gear and that ready and jumping in with me? We've sort of picked up a bit of speed now. This fish is towing us around at about 4 or 5 knots. It's going to have to start getting tired soon because I'm getting tired. Kyle's just about to jump in, come over and give me a hand. Good work, mate. Kyle's just informed me that I haven't got a lot of line left on my electric fence reel. I started with 250 metres, so it's time to start hauling it back. And just to negate the loose line on the floor, Kyle's just winding it up, so kind of negates that danger. This fish still got plenty of tow in it, and I hope it's tiring out because I'm tiring fast under the sun. As you can see, there's absolutely no wind here, and out of the shade we must be sort of 35 degrees here. It's really hot. I'm just sort of pulling hand over hand. This is just like hand lining when I was a kid on snapper, except this fish is well over 100 kilos, I'd say, looking at the size of him. There he is. Go, wind. Oh, the fish came up and jumped then, and I got a bit of slack line as he came towards me now. That's my worst fear, really. It doesn't really bother me so much while he's pulling away like this. It's when he jumps back towards me, I'm going to wind up with a whole lot of slack. And then when that slack goes whipping back out again, or if he comes straight at the boat, there's not really a hell of a lot I can do. Please, please God, let me have this one. Any sort of big game fish, the fish are generally lost in the first 2 minutes or the last minute or so. And we've survived this first 2 minutes. Now, we're getting, well, the fish is still probably 30 or 40 metres away, but we're closing down on it. It's still swimming away and it's still towing us, but I'm just managing to hand over hand a bit of line. I'm starting to get a bit of cramp in the forearms. But I tell you what, adrenaline will get me home, I'm sure, because it's pumping through me now. I want this fish really badly, really badly. Okay, it's starting to dig in again. I don't know if you can see it there, but we've just accelerated a bit of speed and it's towing us into the current too. This fish has probably towed us a good couple of miles now, and not really any sign of tiring yet, unfortunately. It hasn't, aside from its initial jumps, it hasn't jumped a hell of a lot, and it's those jumps that tire the fish out. I've decided I don't really want to let it take anymore. I'm just going to make it tow us. I am very conscious about the leader chafing off on the hook. I've had it happen a lot before. When you hook fish on a bait and that leader gets into the corner of the mouth, they've got an extremely powerful jaw, marlin, extremely powerful, and they crush that leader and it can break off. It's right down here. Okay, it's going to take some now. Fish is right down here, it's digging in. I'm really worried about it changing direction. Just get ready on the outboard as well if I tell you you need to reverse for whatever reason. Okay, the fish is digging down. Spent a long time on the surface. Now it's digging deep. Fish has stopped digging. Hopefully he's starting to get tired. How long have we been on it, do you think?
Half an hour.
Oh, good. Hopefully that means it's... Here it comes, Kez. Roll. Roll, it's right here, I can see it. There he is. There he is. He's still got a bit of go in him. Oh dear, I'm getting slack. Okay. Still got a bit of go in him. He's veering around this way slightly, the fish. I just don't want to pull his head too hard because the last thing I want to do is roll him over and have him jump under the camera boat. You ready, Steph, in case he comes your way? Because the line's pulling from that side at the moment, so when I pull, I could arc him round towards you. Okay, now I'm pulling from the other side now, I think. He's still got heaps of grunt. He's just sitting below the surface, just tailing away. See his line, his tail's thumping against the line. I can feel all the thumps. Oh, this is beautiful. Look at that, eh, mate? That is incredible. He's just sitting below the surface. He's still got the skipjack tuna wrapped around his head, and I'm not sure that he's hooked that well. I think he might just be foul hooked on the back of the head, actually. He's all lit up.
That is
stunning. That is amazing. If nothing else, just to see that like that.
Oh, we're off.
Okay, now, he's just put the afterburners on. Now, yeah, I'm not sure how well he's hooked. The skipjack tuna's still stuck to the top of his head. And it looks like the... Oh, he's a nice fish. He's a beautiful fish. Really nice. Look at that, mate. Come and have another peek. Look at that. Look at that, mate.
That's what we do this for.
Kyle just said it right there. This is what we do this for. That's beautiful. Here he comes. He's coming up now. Oh, he's digging in. He's digging in. I'm going to pay him out some line. Oh, this is amazing. That electric neon blue, there's nothing in nature like it. The colour of it is amazing. We've caught it on camera before, this lit up colour, but the cameras never ever quite do it justice. He's digging down deep. He's just about out of sight now. He's running down. I can still see him okay now. I've got his head. I've got his head up. I've just seen his head turn up. Oh, here he goes. He's coming for a jump. Kez, he's going to jump over here. Ready? Here he goes. Here he goes. Oh, no, he pulled out at the... Here he is. He's coming to break the surface. There he is. Oh, he's a nice one. And it looks like he's only foul hooked. He's lassoed. He's in the dorsal. Now he's heading this way towards that boat. Okay, so I haven't already mentioned this. Don't try this at home. It's or at home or 20 miles out at sea. I've wired in excess of 1,000 big game fish. By wiring, I mean when they've been brought to the boat, I've handlined them in. So I know a fair bit about what these fish are going to do. I've got a support crew with me. So don't anyone rush out there and go to try and catch a fish like this on a handline, because it can go pear-shaped pretty quick. He's just got his head down at the moment. Okay, he's got his head down. He's that way now. Man. Oh, no, he's pulling line down. I don't really want to hold too tight now that I've seen that he's not hooked the best. But on the other hand, I don't want the leader to wear out, because I've seen it, it's running. If you can imagine, he's sort of hooked on the top of the head, but the leader's running back through his mouth, which is kind of my worst fear, really, because it's going to be stuck in both jaw hinges.
Again,
yeah, nah, but he's down deep. He's got his head down. Just stay there, please, mate. Ah, I'm going to give him some. I need to try and get his head back up somehow. He's digging deep again. He's showing no signs of tiring. It's after, must be getting close to 40 minutes now. He's just not tiring, but I can tell you I am. Come up, baby. Come up, mate. I've got a couple of wraps on my glove now, which has stopped the line going out. He's digging down and just stretching me. It's sort of a stalemate. I'm not getting any in, he's not taking any out, but the longer this goes on, the more it's in favour of the fish, because that line's wearing. Every second longer this goes on, that line's rubbing in that sharp corner of his mouth. Come on, you're coming home, baby. Coming home. Please. Tell you what, once I take Once I get a hold of that bill, it's going to take a lot to make me let it go, mate. I'd have to rip my arms off. And you've probably seen on our show, guys get extremely exhausted winding these on rod and reel. And on rod and reel, you've got a drag system that plays out and some gears to make it a lot easier, smoothen the fight. But I'm one to one in a straight line with the fish here, right from the word go. And it's hard work. A lot of people may recall a story by Ernest Hemingway, famous novel, The Old Man and the Sea, where an old man goes out fishing and he hooks a giant blue marlin on a hand line and he fights it for hours and hours and through the night. Well, this is slightly different because I've gone out and intentionally tried to, hook a marlin on the hand line. It's probably a little bit more like the madman in the sea. But I can tell you, it's one of the biggest fishing challenges I've ever encountered. And I just really, really want it to come off. Okay, he's changing direction too. You can see the boat's spinning around. He's digging down. Oh, it's getting tenuous, very. I don't want to change the angle of pull. Because we've been pulling from this angle for so long, we know that at least the hook's going to hold. If the fish swims off in the other direction, that hook can tear out so easy. I've seen it, it's not in terribly well. Really quite nervous about the whole scenario. Do you want to just go reverse, please, mate? We'll see if we can get some angle. Just slow, mate, just nice and slow. Just tick back. Slowly, just slow. Notice I'm able to pull the line now without wrapping. Means he may be starting to tie up. Or he could, on the other hand, just be having a rest. Because he's not jumping or swimming at high speed, he can just cruise along, pump oxygen through his gills and re-oxygenate all the muscles right throughout the fish. And you've got to remember, this is a fish much bigger than me, like a lot bigger than me. And it's one giant muscle. And that giant muscle in the fish that starts at its head goes all the way back to the tail. It's designed to do one thing, and that's kick that tail. And the tail would be from tip to tip, about five feet. So you can imagine the power it can generate. Well, I can assure you, I can testify to how much power it's got. It just doesn't want to give up. Okay, I've got Kyle with the motor in reverse now, so he can't tow us so easy. Oh, it also means I can't really hang on. He's still dragging us forward against the motor. But at least it's now it's harder work for him to pull us against the motor.
These motors are working fucking hard, mate.
Yeah. Kyle's just saying the motor's working really hard, but it's not getting anywhere because we're getting dragged against the motor. And I can feel every bit of it in my arms now. This must tire him out. The line's going to break or he's going to tire out. Something has got to give. It's got to give soon. Either he's going to win or I'm going to win. In the next 5 minutes or less, there's going to be a result to this, for better or worse. I might have just pulled his head around. He's coming right up to the surface. Okay, hand over hand, you're going to get some slack now. Something's got to give. Will it be me? Will it be the fish or will it be the line? This has got to be tiring him. It's got to be. The trouble is, because he's not really hooked, it's not hurting him. He's just kind of lassoed. So I'm feeling it. Here he goes. I think he's going to come out here. He's right up on top. He must be dragging us at 3 or 4 knots against the motor in reverse. It's got to be tiring him out. Something's got to give. You guys might want to come in a little bit closer if you want. His head's around this way at the moment. I just want you maybe... Oh, he's a good one, man. He's a good one. Come right in and have a look at him, mate. Clip it back on itself. Okay, I got him by the belt. Thank you, mate. I've got no energy.
Well done, man.
No energy to shake your hand. It is a nice fish. This fish was so hard to tire out because it never ever went on a big long screaming run. I sort of held on to it. He was breathing up, but This fish is totally exhausted, so am I. I'm gonna now attempt with my tired arms to bring this fish on board and take it home to smoke it. I am so, so happy, but I'm so exhausted. We've done it, team. We have done it. This is really amazing. This fish is not even hooked. It's just the bait's obviously gone through his mouth. He's shaking his head. It's gone around and just looped over the dorsal. I mean, look, that isn't even hooked. That was hook just fell out then. I didn't have to work that out. It was just looped onto his dorsal and lassoed through his mouth. And you can see there where it's been crimped, where that's been in the corner of his mouth. And very, very fortunate that didn't bust through the leader, but doesn't matter now because it's in the boat. It's right where I wanted it to be for the last hour. All I've wanted it is to be here, and here it is. Well, right now, I've got about 100 kilograms more weight in this boat than when I started this morning. And because it's right in the middle of the heat of the day, and partly because I'm exhausted, we're gonna get this fish back to get it weighed and then smoked. And there's probably going to be a bit of a party at my place tonight. So on the way home, I think, guys, we'll stop and get some crayfish and some power and a few beers on the way home. See you back at the boat ramp, eh?
We hope you enjoyed this classic episode. But if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.